In this video, we're going to be covering some technical stuff. So if you're looking to just sit down and relax and watch a YouTube video, you might want to check out some of the other ones. If you're following along in the Frankenlab and you're trying to get to the point where you want to make your panel actually do something, this is the video you've been waiting for. So in our last video, we created some buttons and we gave each button a name. Now we're going to learn how to actually connect that name to a signal so the buttons do something. So let's get started. Once a button is properly defined, our next goal is to pair it up with the signal that we wish for it to control when it's activated. We can look at the two objects that we want to join. When the button is pressed, it must affect the HAL UI signal associated with that button. These objects are networked together in the post GUI file. We'll also add a variable that's used internally by the system and can also be used by us should we need to supply information to another object or process. In the example above, the panel, pyVCP, has a button, X minus, that gets pressed by a user. This is networked to the HAL user interface. The arrows show the flow of the information. And this is the actual post GUI HAL file. It looks a little frightening right now, but it's really not that bad. It's a lot of repetition for each of the different buttons. We're going to start up the step configuration wizard and we're going to tell it to modify an existing program. Obviously this is going to be our Frankenlabs. Now all I'm doing is going in here like I normally would if I was going to set a switch or something up, and I want to get to this point. Now you remember before we included this, we included a custom panel. We included the connections to the HAL, and we started off with a blank program. Now, if I set this at this point, the program that we wrote, the panel that we wrote, will be erased. Now, if you'll look, you'll see that we've got our buttons that we created in the last video, and we don't want these to go away. We want to do something with them. But I want to show you what happens when you go through step configuration. Now, we haven't changed anything, or so it would appear. When we get ready to launch Frankenlabs, watch what happens. It gets a crash. If we go down into the debug section, this line is telling us what the problem is. There's a file, custom post GUI.HAL. What this does is this is where a lot of the connections and so forth are set up. And whenever this thing goes through, the step configuration goes through, after a panel's been created, it automatically assumes that in your pyVCP panel somewhere, you've got a spindle speed indicator. If you do, and if it's named exactly like this, you're fine. If not, it crashes. So what do we do about that? We go into gedit, and we open up this post GUI file, and sure enough in this line right here is a pyVCP panel spindle speed. And what it's trying to do is we're going to be telling it that we want to turn on the spindle and go some speed. There's a possibility we may tell it 500.3 revolutions per minute or something. So it's going to start this little piece of math called absolute, and it's going to pass it through there. And it's going to kick out an absolute spindle velocity, and it's also going to try and push it forward to the spindle speed. Well, right now we don't need this, so we can comment it out. All right? Down inside of here is this spindle at speed LED. We don't have that either. We can turn that off. Now, there is a variable called spindle at speed. And your G code won't function unless this is true. So it sets that. So basically, because it passed through, it added all these extra lines. So we comment these out, we'll leave this one alone, tell it save, and now when we go to open up Frankenlabs, you'll see that the Frankenlabs opens normally. So we need to go in now and make the changes. But we're at the point where we can no longer use the step config, because if we do, we're going to mess this up. So from now on, any modifications that we do, we're going to be doing manually. Now, if we go into our home file right here, this is our LinuxCNC. This is where everything lives that we're doing. Okay? Now, we don't want to make a mistake that we can't recover from. So what I do is I copy this, and then I have a directory called archive, and I go in there and paste in my files until it replace all. So you see I've got my Frankenlab backed up, and then I've got my step config backed up. The reason I'm doing that is because for our Frankenlab, I have deleted the step config now, because I don't want to ever accidentally go into it and make a mistake. So from now on, everything that we do is going to be done by editing these files here. Okay? So here's our panel, here's our HAL configuration, here's our post GUI. Look familiar? Okay? We're going to be going in and making changes to that. And we're going to be going into the INI file, which sets up a lot of different things, how the machine functions and so forth. We'll do that in another video. But all of these things, we're going to be doing them manually. So if we make a mistake and it crashes and burns, we can always go back to the archive, pull those files and copy them back to the configs so we don't lose anything. Very important, don't forget to do that. Okay. So, we want to make these buttons active. We need to tie them to something. So let's take a look in the HAL configuration. And this is all of the different signals and parameters and everything that are used to make the machine work. So if I go into pins, all right, we have our HAL user interface right here. And there's a whole bunch of different things here. One of them, for example, is jog speed. Now this, if we push a jog speed to it, it's what the current jog speed is going to become. All right. We also have the jog itself. We've got three different axes. We have the X, the Y, and the Z axis. So if I go in here, you can see there's a whole bunch of different stuff that we can access, and it looks kind of confusing. So what we'll do is we'll only take a look at this one for right now. So this is our x-axis. 0 is x, 1 is y, and 2 is z. So we're only going to be concerned with plus and minus. All right. So we're going to open up a watch window here, and I want to show you what happens. If we go into our pyVCP down here, you see we've created a Z plus, Z minus, you know, so forth. We've created these buttons. So basically, I want to take this X plus right here, and I want to tie it to this right here. So I want to tie the HAL UI jog.0 plus to the pyVCP X plus, and I want to take the HAL jog 1 plus and connect it to the Y plus and so forth. And to do that, we're going to go into gedit. Now I've already done a lot of the typing here, and I just kind of want to run by it and show you what we've done. Just clean it up a little bit. I'm using tab to set my spacing. So here's what we have. We have a value here. This is HAL user interface under the jog section, axis 0, minus. Here's the same thing with plus. And these little arrows indicate direction. So if I read this line starting at the left, it says I want to make a network. I want to create a variable called jog minus, panel jog minus. And these can be any name that's not already used. Okay? And I'm saying that whatever this state is, I'm going to push it to this little variable because I may want to use it later. And where is this thing going to get its signal from? It's going to get it from our pyVCP X minus button. So what this one line means is, if some joker mashes down on the X minus button, I want you to transfer that signal to the actual how user jog and start moving the machine. And I also want you to update this variable, which we may or may not use in the future. Okay, same thing for the Y axis, same thing for the Z axis. And then down here, I'm going to do the same thing with the slider. I'm going to take that floating point number and push it to the jog speed, which is also going to go into some variable that we may or may not use later. And the only thing that we kept out of the whole original file was this one little line here where we set the spindle at speed to the value of true. That's the only thing that we saved. Alright, so we go in here and save all this, and we'll be adding more stuff later as we get a more complex panel, but for now this is it. And when I run Frankenlabs, assuming I haven't made any typos, it's going to come up. I can start the machine, and now watch, when I hit this X left, you notice the X axis actually moves, the Y actually moves, Z. And if you notice the velocity here, you see how it's 1,000? Well, if I take this and I kick it up to 1680, for example, you'll notice it matches it. So all of our buttons are functional. That should be enough for this video. Go ahead and do that and play around with it. Then later on, we'll add some more functionality and some more power to our system. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it.